Arrow is something that immediately you put into your mouth, you know whether it's well done or not. This arrow is well done, guys. So, you don't want to cook your arrow and then they see what running out of the arrow. Nope. Kanda, cow skin, you call it.
Mesdames, mesdemoiselles et messieurs, voici, je vous apporte la recette du héros préparée comme à Manfé, préparée comme à Kumba, préparée comme les autochtones du héros le font. Voici la recette du héros et en train de se faire à la cuisine Moti. Veuillez abonner à ma chaîne.
Hello everyone, welcome to Consistence Place channel, welcome to Moti's Kitchen. Today, guys, I bring to you a Cameroonian national delicacy. I'm bringing to you a Cameroonian delicacy, eru and fufu. This is a meal that is from the Bayangi tribe and is consumed all over in the national territory. And this is a meal that is a signature to the Cameroonian people. And even in Cameroon, they cook it in different ways. But today I'm going to be bringing it to you in the way the Anglophones, the Bayangis, they could prepare it. Eru is something that doesn't have a lot of spices going into it. It doesn't have a lot of ingredients like garlic, ginger, onion, all those other things. And it's very tricky here because, guys, what makes eru taste good is the skills. So I'm going to show you all those tricks today on how you can cook eru and get the title Mami Eru, okay? So let's move over to the ingredients. This is just some dry fish that I had pre-frozen. Then this is crayfish, 1.5 cups of crayfish. This is some cow skin that I had already pre-boiled and frozen, guys. And then I have here 6 pounds of spinach, and I also have here a bowl of eru. This is dry eru from Cameroon. Usually, preferably, it's good to soak a few hours before you cook. You can still cook it dry, or you can soak it for a few hours before you cook it. So right here I have palm oil, that's what they generously put in eru. But guys, I do a lot of trick and cheating in my cooking. That's how I put add vegetable oil, because we are in the here in the US, palm oil is very scarce. So we cheat a little bit with this. So I have my seasoning salt here, my hot pepper, and my salt. In Cameroon we use water leaf, but here we don't have water leaf, so I use like the frozen spinach. Feel free to use fresh spinach if you can. So right here, guys, I just want to boil my goat meat. I have 2.2 pounds of goat per packet, so altogether 4.4 pounds of goat meat, which is about 2 kilograms of goat meat. And I'm just going to boil that in my pressure cooker. This pressure cooker is kind of like the biggest size I saw on Amazon. And I bought it because I have a big family. I used to have the small one, guys. Check this out. I used to have the small one, but then I decided to go in for the big one. The small one, it's a rice boiler. At the same time, I boil, like, you know, like the dry kanda that comes from Cameroon, I boil that in here. I boil beans in there, I boil rice, I boil everything. Plantain, I cook my pepper soup, like the plantain pepper soup in here, and that's really good. So I do a lot with this. So I want to put my goat meat inside because that will go real fast. Pour that in my pressure cooker. See, this is removable. I don't know if this is 8 ounces or 16 ounces. I'll check it and let you know. So I just put that in there, pour my water. Oh, I don't want, the thing with eru, I don't want a lot of stock. I'll just season that up and I'm good to go. The good thing with this pressure cooker is that the amount of water you put in is the amount that will come. It doesn't dry off the water, but it cooks it adequately. So just season it right. And just going to take me about 20 minutes to cook my goat. So I need to lock it up. Lock it and then put it on pressure. I'll put it on pressure. And then I'll add the time. I'll put 20 minutes. That was 21, I'll just let it there. And then it will cook. Our goat meat is boiling. Our goat meat is boiling in the pressure cooker. I'm soaking my eru in water before washing it. I'm soaking while I do all the rest of the preparation. The eru at least will be soaking in water. This eru is some forest leaves that have been sliced. and dried from Cameroon. So I'm just going to finish in the pot. I'm just going to set this in the fire and start the preparation. So while our goat meat is boiling and then our spinach we just put in the fire, we are going to be eating this eru with plantain fufu. And plantain fufu, it comes, you can buy, get it from African store. This is 1 packet, 1 pound 8 ounces. Yeah, this plantain on itself usually is very elastic. I personally, I don't like it when it is too elastic. And this is mashed potato. Mashed potato by itself is loose, so I mix my potato and the plantain fufu to give it a medium elasticity, not too elastic, medium elasticity. And usually tastes very good. So many people who have eaten this that I made keep asking me, what fufu is this? It's so smooth. And you guys will see that mashed potato is loose and plantain is stretchy. So when I mix the two, it's somewhere in the middle and not too stretchy and not too loose, okay? So you can put one box of plantain is enough, and then you can bump it up to your quantity with mashed potato. That would be fine. The plantain, I just open it and pour it in water. I have water half full in this, so I just pour it. And how I do this, I just mix it up to mix in the water. Quantity is cold water anyway. I like to just mix mine up with cold water when it's smooth, and then I put it on the fire and start stirring. That way I am assured that I'm not going to end up with lumps, because when the lumps hit hot water, it's difficult to break down. You can see now it's smooth, so smooth. So I'm just going to put it in the fire and start stirring right away. So just put fire underneath the fufu and start stirring till it gets smooth, okay? So right now the spinach is boiling. So what I do is I season the spinach before I add, that's the way I do mine. I season the spinach before I add my eru. Just go ahead, season my spinach. I put 3 tablespoons of seasoning salt, and then I'll put about 2 tablespoons of crushed red pepper, is hot. And then I put my salt, 2 tablespoons of salt. Then I mix that in. When I mix it, I taste, guys, because it's easy to mix spinach. That's why just want to make sure I taste it. At this point I know at the baseline how my seasoning is going to be. Keep in mind, you don't put onion in eru. It's the skill that makes it taste good. Yeah, I think my baseline seasoning is good to go, at least, you know what I mean. I have soaked my eru in water. That's kind of also help us washing. I have to strain it out. It would have been better if I could have soaked it like a few hours before, but nevertheless, soaking it at least before play the game. I'll add this to my spinach. When I add it to my spinach, now I get a good mix. Give it a good mix. Loosen up the eru while I mix. Just try to make sure that the mixture, the eru blends in well with the spinach. That will take some time. You'll definitely have to do it until it blends well. Well blended. That way you know if the eru is too much for the spinach, or the spinach is too much for the eru. You can add the eru if it is too soft. It's better to get it too soft, so you can always add eru, because, and if it is too hard, you can add the spinach. If you have unfrozen or fresh spinach, you can always add that. You obtain the best results when you gauge everything the right amount. Fufu is getting thicker and thicker, you see that? See, it's getting thicker and thicker, which is good, and it will be well cooked that way. That's when we're gonna add the mashed potato, and then our eru is fully blended in. See, this eru is fully blended. See that? So right now, when it's fully blended like this, I'm comfortable with them. I usually don't want to be doing this when the meat is inside. I always do it before I put the meat, so I can really gauge the consistency of the mixture of the eru and the water leaf. So right now it's fully blended, and then the mixture is okay. Now I'm going to pour in my oil. Probably about 2 cups of palm oil. See that? 2 cups of palm oil.
So when I put my palm oil and I see that, because you have to put palm oil generously into the food, never stingy, but see that the palm oil is hidden. You have to like see oil when you cook this food. So right now, all my palm oil has been emptied into the food and I do not have more. What I do, I'm gonna add it up with vegetable oil. I'm just gonna add a little bit of vegetable oil in it. And mix that up. Mix that up. When I mix it up now, I'm going to just make sure that my seasoning is what I want. If my seasoning is what I want, I move on to the next step. See that? The oil is still not there. When it dries up, it doesn't gonna show like oil is anything there. The seasoning is good so far. Getting thicker and thicker. See, it's thicker and thicker and thicker. Yeah. So now we're just going to add the mashed potato. So right now we pour our dry fish and our crayfish. Mix that in. We just mix in the crayfish. We have to be very generous with our crayfish at this point, you know. That's what determines the taste of this food, guys. If you're stingy with your crayfish, you're not going to obtain that flavor. Stir in our crayfish.
Oh my God.
So this just stirred in our crayfish and meat. This is the cow skin in there.
I want to decompress the pressure so that I can take out my good meat and then move on to my arrow. When it's decompressed, you'll be able to open. If it doesn't decompress, if it does not decompress, you cannot. Oh my God, I keep burning myself. If it doesn't decompress, you cannot be able to move the cover. So right now that it's decompressed, see that? Oof, that's hard, man. See guys, my meat is ready. So the stock is still there and the meat is already cooked. The stock didn't dry up, everything is maintained. So guys, I'll save the stock for my pepper soup or something else that I wanna cook. And then pull out the meat. Just pour my meat in here and probably add the meat. Just add more of the meat in there. So now we just try to stir everything together. The thing with arrow is when you make arrow, you have to let it dry, the water that was in to dry up completely. When you leave it wet from the water, it doesn't taste like, you start chewing it like a cow. Chwa, chwa, chwa. So arrow is cooking in Morty's kitchen. So right now we're going to be adding our mashed potato. Go see how thick and how, at least the plantain is cooked, so we just add our mashed potato that way till it gets thickened up the way we want. Just add the mashed potato and you stir it. I like the color, guys. See the color? I really love it. And they eat this with water fufu. We don't have water. I don't have water fufu here. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. So right now I don't. This is the day I do my best fufu to eat with arrow is this plantain fufu mixed with mashed potato. I love it. Make it really hard enough.
The trick is to make it to be hard. You enjoy it better harder. You occasionally stir the eru to make sure it's not stuck underneath the pot. Eru is cooking in Morty's kitchen. See, the eru is rich. Eru is good for hemoglobin, blood. It brings up your blood level. If you are anemic, eru is a way to go. Rich in protein, you have goat meat in there, crayfish, dried fish, cow skin, all you can name it. So eru is very, very healthy, and the palm oil is rich in healthy constituents. So guys, and spinach loaded and packed in there, you cannot outlive the benefits of spinach to the health. So eru is definitely a way to go. Just let it simmer and dry off, and you stir regularly. So I think it's good to go now. Like I said, the number one thing of eru, the number one thing is you mix the eru and the spinach to be at a smooth consistency without the eru being too much. Because if the eru is too much, it's going to be hard. Without the spinach being too much, if the spinach is too much, it's going to be too soft. And then you generously add your palm oil, or the palm and vegetable oil if you want. Usually just add your palm oil generously until it's enough. And then the third step now is generously add crayfish and mix it in without the obstacles. And then remember we seasoned it already at the spinach level. And then you add every other thing now and stir until the water dries off. Just make sure it's stir, making sure it's not burnt underneath, until the water dries off and all you can see is oil. The oil content that is left, that's all you should be seeing left. So that's how it should be. And your eru is ready. So I think we can turn off our fire now. This plantain fufu, pounded plantain fufu, that's it. This tastes so good, guys. See, it's not too stretchy, just not too stretchy, not too loose, just at the right level. Fufu is ready now. All I need to do is, it's so hard, and that's why I love it hard. So, because if this thing is not hard, you will be sticky on your fingers. So it needs to be hard and smooth. See that? I apologize, I'm not that strong to pull this, but I managed to mix it anyway. Because it's a lot of fufu eat too. If it was a small quantity, it would be easier. But right now it's a lot of quantity. We're gonna wrap that off. Turn off the fire, wrap it up.
Alors les amis, nous passons à la gustation du eru et du couscous plantain. Ladies and gentlemen, we are done cooking, so now let's move on to tasting this delicacy. So before we do this, our regular tradition, we pop something after hard work of cooking this Cameroon delicacy. We kind of like inaugurate it with some good drink. You know what I mean? This is a sparkling red grape cocktail juice. So let's pray. I already washed my hands. I'll just wash that one more time. So thank you for the food, Lord. Bless this food, sanctify the food, provide to those who have nothing to eat, in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. So guys, I can't wait to dig in. If you have watched this video up to this time, please don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to hit like if you like this video, and share if you want to share this experience with someone else. And until then, guys, thank you for watching, and see you in our next video. Bye.